Hello everyone. In this video, I'll show you how to create a master sheet in Google Sheets to sync data from multiple Google Sheets tabs or workbooks. If you manage data across several Google Sheets tabs or workbooks, you know how challenging it can be to analyze them. Creating a dashboard can be tricky too. Instead of copying and pasting the latest data every time those sheets are updated, you can create a master sheet. This master sheet will sync all your data in one place. This video is divided into two parts. In the first part, I'm going to create a master sheet using the data from tabs within the same workbook. Then I will create a master sheet using data from different Google Sheets workbooks. Let's dive in and learn how to combine or sync datasets from multiple tabs into one range. We're going to create an array by combining the three ranges from these three tabs. In Google Sheets, curly brackets are used to create an array. Start by opening a curly bracket and including the data range you want at the top. Then, add a semicolon and include the second data range, and so on. Finally, close the curly bracket and press Enter. The three data sets will be stacked in the order you included them in the array. Remove the last row number from the data range to ensure any new data added to these ranges is automatically included. However, there is one issue with this method. When the source tabs have empty rows, they are also included in the master sheet. To avoid this, you can wrap this array with the query function. To avoid getting empty rows, we can use the query function to select only the rows with data. We do this by writing the query to select all rows where column 1 is not null. Now, you can see that when you add or update data in the tabs, the master sheet is automatically updated as well. In this query formula, the asterisk imports all columns in the range. But if you only need specific columns, you can specify them by their names, like col1 and col2, instead of using the asterisk. Let's see how we can do the same when your data is stored in different Google Sheets workbooks. To import data from external workbooks, we'll use the import range function. This function has two parameters. The first parameter is the URL of the Google Sheet. You can also use the ID of the Google Sheets workbook instead of the URL. The second parameter is the data range you need to import. To explain this, I've stored the previous datasets in three different workbooks. Let's write the import range function for these three sheets. For the first parameter, you can use either the sheet's URL or its ID. I prefer using the spreadsheet ID. It's shorter and cleaner. This makes your functions easier to maintain. You can find the spreadsheet ID between the /and/edit parts of the URL. The data range should include the sheet name and the specific range. Including the sheet name is optional. If you don't include it, the function will always import data from the first sheet in the workbook. If you change the order of the sheets, it will import data from the new first sheet. To avoid confusion in the future, always include the sheet name in the data range. After inserting the import range formula, the data won't appear immediately. To retrieve the data, hover over the cell with the formula and click Allow Access. This step connects the two spreadsheets. Whenever you pull data from a new source spreadsheet for the first time, you'll need to grant permission. Instead of directly inserting the spreadsheet ID and range string in the import range function, I'll create a separate table for these two parameters. The second and third data ranges start from the second row to avoid repeating the header row. Let's copy and paste the spreadsheet ID from each source spreadsheet. We can reference these cells to use those values. This approach shortens the formula, making it easier to understand. When using this method, you don't need to wrap these values in double quotes. When using multiple import range functions, you'll need to allow access to each external sheet individually. If you combine all import range functions with curly brackets without prior access, the prompt to allow access won't trigger. As a result, the data won't load. After you allow access to each source spreadsheet, you can combine these import range functions using curly brackets. Be sure to put semicolons between the functions. Finally, wrap this with the query function to avoid empty rows in the master sheet. This query function will select only rows where col1 is not empty. You can see the master spreadsheet gets automatically updated when you update the source spreadsheets. Thank you for watching.